Hello, everyone. This is Karen.
Hi, everybody. I'm Shane.
Today, we're looking at a lesson called Close Test. A new cleanup crew takes flight. And the vocabulary words are crew.
Crew.
The owner had to hire a new kitchen crew.
Meanwhile.
Meanwhile.
I will start preparing dinner. Meanwhile, please clean and set the table.
Okay. Feathered.
Feathered.
It takes about 6 to 8 weeks for baby ducks to become feathered.
Cigarette.
Cigarette.
Smoking cigarettes is unhealthy for you.
So we're talking about something really cool that I have never heard of before.
So basically, these are like bird cleaner, not bird cleaners, cleaning birds?
Kind of. It's like a cleanup crew.
Yeah.
And then these are birds, right?
Birds that clean up at a theme park in France.
Mm-hmm. I never knew that you can train birds to do that.
It seems like it would be pretty cool. I think if I were to go to this theme park, I would just bring garbage with me from home so that I could just throw it everywhere, just litter, and then watch the birds catch it.
Shane.
What? No?
I can't believe that you would do that.
But,
that's the whole point why they train the birds to do that. So then people would think, even if the birds, even the birds can pick up garbage, then why can't we?
Oh, so it's supposed to make us realize that we should pick up litter, not throw it onto the ground.
Yes. And we have to be more aware.
I missed the point.
But
I want to see them pick up the litter, especially now that I read about this. If I go to that theme park, I will definitely want to see them pick up litter.
Okay, maybe try one. It's okay.
Okay.
Okay, enjoy today's lesson and learn more about these cool birds.
Don't litter.
A new cleanup crew takes flight. Visitors to the Puy de Fou theme park in France should check out the famous falconry show, where they'll see hundreds of trained birds do cool tricks. Meanwhile, they might also notice another feathered team doing something special, picking up trash.
Hi, I'm Jeff.
Hi, I'm Hanny.
Welcome. Today we'll be reading from an article entitled, A New Cleanup Crew Takes Flight. Before we begin reading, let's define the first of today's vocabulary words. Here, a crew is a group of people who work together. A crew is usually a group of employees who work together on an airplane, a boat, a train, or even a spaceship. Yeah, a crew is not unlike a staff. For example, the owner had to hire a new kitchen crew.
One note, the title of our lesson might give you the impression that we'll be talking about airplanes and the people who clean airplanes. To be clear though, we will not be talking about an airplane cleanup crew.
Right. No crews, no airplane cleanup crews. Okay? But hey, we will be discussing things that fly. Birds. Pretty good, yeah.
Yeah, that's right. 今天的课文标题是 A new cleanup crew takes flight. Cleanup 这个名词就表示清理啊，清扫。那么 take flight 它有飞行的意思，也可以用来比喻成功，所以在这边它是一语双关。可是今天的课文跟飞机上的清洁人员是没有关系的哦。我们的主角其实是一种鸟类。那赶快来读课文吧。Okay, let's start reading from our lesson. The first sentence of our article says, Visitors to the Puy de Fou theme park in France should check out the famous falconry show, where they'll see hundreds of trained birds do cool tricks.
Oh, by the way, a falcon is a bird. A large bird capable of hunting and eating prey. The word falconry, by the way, refers to the keeping of falcons. Yeah, people who engage in falconry train and maybe even do tricks with their pet falcons and other birds too. Maybe other birds like falcons as well.
Indeed. And as we'll learn, falcons and some other birds as well can do some pretty amazing stuff. Anyway, more on this French theme park. If a person goes to this theme park, he or she is sure to see some birds doing cool tricks. But that's not all.
Right. Next we read, meanwhile, they might also notice another feathered team doing something special, picking up trash, which is pretty cool, I'd say. Anyway, let's define the second and third vocabulary words of the day right now. The second vocabulary word of the day is the adverb meanwhile. The word meanwhile is used to say that two or more things are happening together, or maybe even at the same time. So, while you're watching a bird show at this theme park, you might also see birds picking up garbage, too. For example, I will start preparing dinner. Meanwhile, please clean and set the table.
Okay, and the third vocabulary word of the day is the adjective feathered. Birds have feathers. Here we're using the word feather as a noun. Feathers are the soft things that cover most parts of the body of birds. Humans have body hair, animals have fur, while birds have feathers. As for the word feathered, it's used as an adjective. If something is feathered, it has feathers. For example, it takes about 6 to 8 weeks for baby ducks to become feathered.
Okay, everyone, with that, it's time for our first break. But don't go away. We'll be back soon.
A new cleanup crew takes flight. This team is made up of 6 rooks, a bird similar to a crow. They have been training for over half a year and officially began working this past August. At Puy de Fou, they complete simple tasks such as collecting used cigarettes or pieces of paper on the ground and then placing the trash into a special box.
Welcome back, everyone. Today, Hanny and I are reading from an article titled, A New Cleanup Crew Takes Flight.
Before the break, we learned about a theme park in France. This theme park is pretty cool, especially if you like to see bird tricks.
Yep. People visiting this theme park can take in bird shows. But that's not all. Some of the birds at this theme park can do some pretty special stuff. They can do something pretty cool. They can actually pick up garbage.
Wow. You heard him right, everyone. There is a team of birds at this theme park that picks up trash.
Correct. Now, more on this team of cleanup birds. This team is 6 rooks, a bird similar to a crow. Your options are A, looked down on, B, made sure of, C, put up with, or D, made up of.
好，题目的意思是，这支队伍是六只秃鼻乌鸦，空格，它们是一种类似乌鸦的鸟。那这题是在考我们片语，由于空格前面有 be 动词 is， 那么四个选项都是动词的过去分词，那我们可以得知这个句子它是用被动语态。先来看选项 A， looked down on 表示瞧不起或者是轻视，那么 B， made sure of 表示确认或是弄清楚。C, put up with, 表示忍受、容忍。那么 D, made up of, 它是指由什么什么组成或是构成。那它的用法是整体加上 be made up of, 加上部分。好，根据课文，它应该是要表达这支队伍是由六只秃鼻乌鸦组成的。那其他三个选项语义都不符合，因此这题正确答案是选 D, made up of. So the sentence should read,
This team is made up of 6 rooks, a bird similar to a crow. Rook, huh? Never heard of them. But hey, just because I've never heard tell of them, doesn't mean that they're not super cool birds, right?
Right. These birds are awesome, and they've been doing awesome stuff for quite some time. Get this. They, for over half a year, and officially began working this past August.
Your options are A, will train, B, are training, C, were to train, or D, have been training.
题目的意思是他们空格超过半年，并于去年八月正式开始工作。那这题是来考我们时态。题目的四个选项是动词 train 的不同时态变化。train 这个动词它表示训练。那么空格后方的 for over half a year 表示超过半年。officially began working this past August 表示去年八月正式开始工作。好，那从这两个资讯就可以推断，这支秃鼻乌鸦队伍呢已经受训一段期间了。当我们使用 for 加一段期间，或是使用 since 加上开始的时间点，再搭配现在完成式或现在完成进行式，就可以用来表达某个动作从过去开始一直持续到现在。例如 Jenny has been reading the book for hours. Jenny 看那本书已经看了好几个小时，现在还在看哦。They've known each other since college. 他们从大学就认识了。好，那因此这题最适合的答案是 D, have been training. So the correct sentence should read,
They have been training for over half a year and officially began working this past August. Okay, to be clear,These birds work only at this French theme park, Puy de Fou. They only work there for now, I hope. I hope in the future they work elsewhere too.
Me too. Now let's get into the specifics here. What exactly do these birds do at Puy de Fou?
That's what we'll read about next at Puy de Fou.De Fou. They complete simple tasks, collecting used cigarettes or pieces of paper on the ground, and then placing the trash into a special box. Your options are A, due to, B, such as, C, instead of, or D, in addition to.
题目的意思是在狂人国他们会完成简单的任务。空格，收集地上抽过的烟或纸张，然后将垃圾放入特殊的箱子里面。好，那这题是来考我们连接用语。先来看选项 A, due to, 它是指因为什么，由于什么。B, such as, 是指例如，像是什么什么。C, instead of, 它表示而不是什么，代替什么。D, in addition to, 它是指除了什么什么之外，还有什么什么。好，那么以上四个选项后面都可以接名词或动名词。那么课文提到说，那些秃鼻乌鸦在狂人国里面会完成简单任务，那后面就是要举例说明有哪几项简单任务，像是收集地上抽过的烟或是纸张，然后再把垃圾放进特殊箱子，它是要举例说明。所以这题最适合的答案是 B, such as。So the correct sentence should read,
At Puy de Fou, they complete simple tasks such as collecting used cigarettes or pieces of paper on the ground and then placing the trash into a special box.
Okay, before we take a break, everyone, there's something we need to do. We need to discuss the fourth and final vocabulary word of the day, cigarette. If you've ever seen people smoking,
which you shouldn't do,
What they smoke is a cigarette. A cigarette is a small roll of paper filled with tobacco. It's the small, thin thing that people smoke. For example, smoking cigarettes is unhealthy for you. Smoking is bad for you. Okay, with that, it is time to take another break.
Right, but don't go away. We'll be back soon.
A new cleanup crew takes flight.One may argue that if this task is so simple, then how come humans seem to have such a hard time doing it? This is just the message that Puy de Fou is hoping to show. If birds can learn to throw away garbage, why can't we? Hopefully, seeing these smart birds in action will make people think twice before dropping their litter on the ground.
Welcome back, everyone. Before the last break, we learned that the...Puy de Fou theme park in France has a new cleanup crew. Nothing special, right? Wrong. This is a cleanup crew staffed by birds and birds alone. These birds have been trained to pick up garbage.
Right. These birds can do simple stuff. They can pick up cigarette butts and pieces of paper and stuff like that. But this begs the following question. Why? Why train birds to do simple stuff like this? Why are humans incapable of doing this simple stuff themselves?
Good question, Hanny. Yes, one may argue that if this task is so simple, then how come humans seem to have such a hard time doing it? But apparently, that's the point. Puy de Fou isn't trying to solve their trash problem by training these birds to pick up trash. In fact, the people at Puy de Fou are trying to send people a message, namely that training animals to do what we should do ourselves is bonkers.
You bet. This is just the message that Puy de Fou is hoping to show.
Right on, Hanny. If birds can learn to garbage, why can't we? Your options are A, end up, B, turn into, C, throw away, or D, figure out.
题目的意思是，如果鸟类可以学会把垃圾空格，我们为什么不行呢？那这题是在考我们偏语动词。先来看选项 A， end up 是指最后怎么样，以什么什么告终。B turn into 它表示变成、成为。C throw away 是指扔掉。D figure out 它是指弄懂、弄清楚或者是想出，像是弄懂某个情况啊，或者是想出某个解决问题的方法。好，那这个题目应该很简单，垃圾当然是要丢掉咯。那如果鸟类它们都可以学会把垃圾丢到这个特殊的箱子，知道要如何正确的丢垃圾，我们为什么不行呢？那么空格里最适合填入的片语就是 throw away。Throw away garbage 就表示将垃圾丢进垃圾桶。那其他三个选项语义都不符合，因此这题的正确答案要选 C, throw away.
So the correct sentence should read,
If birds can learn to throw away garbage, why can't we?
Okay, let's start wrapping things up. Our article's final sentence is coming up right now.
Right. It says, Seeing these smart birds in action,will make people think twice before dropping their litter on the ground. Your options are A, exactly, B, fortunately, C, gradually, or D, hopefully.
题目的意思是空格逗号，看见这些聪明的鸟采取行动，会让人类在将垃圾丢到地上之前再仔细想想。这题是在考我们副词，先来看选项 A, exactly 就表示正确地、确切地。B, fortunately, 它是指幸好或是幸运地。C, gradually, 表示逐渐地、逐步地。D, hopefully, 它表示但愿、怀着希望地。好，课文前一句提到说，如果鸟类可以学会把垃圾丢进垃圾桶，我们为什么不行呢？那我们可以推测，课文最后就是要表达期许，希望人们看见那些会捡垃圾的聪明鸟儿，我们会自我反省，不会再随手乱丢垃圾。因此，这题最适合的答案要选 D, hopefully.
So the correct sentence should read,
Hopefully, seeing these smart birds in action,will make people think twice before dropping their litter on the ground. Okay, with that, this month's article, A New Cleanup Crew Takes Flight, is now complete. But as always, I sure hope that everyone enjoyed reading along with us.
Me too. But right now, it is time for a break. But don't go away. We'll be back soon.
与塞车相关的英文怎么说？
欢迎收看《就爱讲英文》，
我是悠悠，
我是 Jay。
上班族最讨厌塞车，塞车就会迟到，迟到就会毛躁。
今天跟大家分享四句塞车相关的英文。一 ，It's always busy during rush hour。二 ，The traffic is bumper to bumper now。三。The traffic jam is so long. 四 If we leave early, we'll beat the traffic.
第一句
It's always busy during rush hour.
尖峰时段总是很多车。
对 ，rush hour 呢，就是上下班人很多的时候。那 rush 就是急急忙忙，
啊、
大家都在赶时间。
Rush
hour。
可是 busy 也是很忙啊。
Busy 呢是很忙的意思，但是呢，它也有什么人来人往、人来车往、
熙熙攘攘、
熙熙攘攘，就是呢人车都很多的意思。
真的，
所以 busy 啊，所以呢，有些路段会塞到
动弹不得。
对、就是，
而且下雨天好可怕哦。
真的，就是可能一个红绿灯，你只前进三公分。这样啊，
三公分多了，
对对对，3.2公分
对啊。
那有些这种情况，我们就可以说是 bumper to bumper。
哇，
哎 ，bumper 呢就是撞的东西，对不对？它就是车子的保险杆，
保险杆
后保险杆、前保险杆 bumper。那修车的人呢，你如果牵车去修，他会说那个是什么 bumper。啊、就是从日文来的、
哦、
bumper 的日文 bumba 这样、嗯，那到那个台语里面就会变成 bumba、嗯、就是 bumba 跟 bumba 要碰在一起，
保险很近了，
保险杆跟保险杆都要快撞在一块了，所以呢 ，the traffic is bumper to bumper。
the traffic is bumper to bumper。
超塞的，
超塞的，
塞车就是 traffic jam。
哎，这个很有趣。
Jam 就是塞，traffic jam。
traffic jam。
对、嗯，所以塞很长。
塞很长。
The traffic jam is so long.
The traffic jam is so long. 到塞到都可以就下来打个麻将啊，抽个烟，或是要唱个歌、跳个舞，
对对，做个瑜伽，
太夸张了，呜、哦，真的。
这个时候我们就会
万叹，生气了，
就会觉得很生气。
我干嘛不早五分钟出门就好了呢？
五分钟有差吗？
是是
我们就会说 ，If we leave early, we'll beat the traffic.
If we leave early, we'll beat.The traffic,
beat the traffic，
打交通，
打交通，哦，字面上就是我们要击败这个车流量，哈、哦，避开车潮，不受影响 ，beat the traffic，、嗯、
beat the traffic。
我们看一下今天的 live action，
beat the traffic，
beat the traffic。Hey Yoyo，
yes，
I'm going to be late. This traffic is crazy during rush hour.、Oh.
Is it that bad?
Yes, the traffic is bumper to bumper now. The traffic jam is so
yeah,
long.
I see. Just drive carefully. Right. Next time you want to beat the traffic, you'd better leave earlier.
All right, I will.
Okay.
See you.
See you.